So next guy is the joke man on the 93.5 morning show. Please big round of applause for Brian Cannon.
New York City, how you doing tonight? Everybody cool? Listen, I noticed the men and the women are using the same bathroom, and I just want to state that Brian Cannon, the piss was on the seat before I got in there, all right? Just so I don't want at the end of the night fucking girls mad at me, you know what I mean? By the way, I'm using my Muslim name tonight. Hasn't been laid. You heard of me? You know, I don't mean to date you. You might be my grandmother, you know that? See, I love my grandmother. She just got married about 2 weeks ago. She had to. She was knocked up. Nah, that ain't right. You gotta be careful with these toilet seats, though. I know a guy actually got AIDS from a toilet seat. He tried to sit down before the last guy got up. Oh, that's not right. That's not right. It's funny, actually, very busy weekend for me in New York. I did a gig in on the West Side last night at a rehab, and I think they like me, because after every joke, they clap like this. What's up with that? You know, it's real weird, because I was, about 3 weeks ago, I was out front, and this guy pulled up in a Camaro with, like, three of his friends. He's like, get away from our fucking club, you faggot. And like, I couldn't just run because, you know, I had this real tight skirt on at the time, you know what I mean? Fucking pumps and shit. Hey, I'm a patriot too. You know, ever since this bullshit with the, you know, shit, you know, people are more patriotic, you know? I actually, you know, I'm a New Yorker too, obviously, right? So I'm so patriotic, I went to the dog pound, I bought an Afghan just to beat the shit out of it. So I'm beating the shit out of this fucking dog. Oh, we got animal lovers here? They're called jokes, I'm sorry. So I'm beating the piss out of this dog. Anyway, this gets good, hang out. Right, so all of a sudden the fucking knock on my door, it's a cop. It's like, hey, how you doing, officer? How's everything? What's the problem? Oh, we got a problem with the disturbance in the area. I heard a dog yelping or something. I was like, oh yeah, it's Afghan. We've been beating the fuck out of it. It's like, hey, you know, officer, where's my manners? Come on in, you wanna take a fucking shot at him or what? Come on. Fucking, he goes, oh, hold on a minute, let me run down to my car and get my New York's fucking police department issued plunger. Oh, now, here we go. Oh, that's fucked up, right? You know that the hand is actually quicker than the eye, so if you jerk me off real quick, no one can see you? All right. Oh, I don't mean that in a bad way. Actually, anyone married out here? Anyone married? Are you married? Yeah, you happy? They say when you're married, you live longer. And I'm like, nah, it just seems longer. I know this one beautiful lady, she was married so many times, she had fucking rice scars on her face. You know what I'm saying? I'm the bad guy now? Actually, I got a divorce about 2 years ago, so I'm a little bitter. We split the house right down the middle. I got the outside. She's a good housekeeper. She kept the fucking house. You know what I'm trying to say? That ain't right. It was funny because it's actually a beautiful night in New York City tonight, right? It's like 50 degrees. Come on, we're having a great time, right? Come on. Give yourself, you know, we're starting to, you know, New York's starting to laugh again. You know what I mean? We're starting to, you know, have a good time again. We got fucking hit, but we ain't out, baby. You know that. So I seen this girl out front. Beautiful fur coat. Hey, it's America. You fucking have a fur coat. That's your business. Just animal rights out. You know, activist, whatever the fuck you want to call it. She's like, oh, you know how many animals had to die for you to get that coat? She goes, yeah, you know how many guys had to fuck to get it? Hey, I don't mean it. So anyway, I'm 40 years old now, right? And all of a sudden, like, I'm looking at Britney Spears on the fucking TV. And it's marketed for guys like me, you know what I mean? Really. But my all-time girl is Janet Jackson. I got a little jungle fever thing going. I love her. I just love her. She's so sexy. But it's not what you think. It's not like right now, you know, with the, I love it, like she was so sexy, you know, when she was on Good Times as Penny. That's what I jerk off to, anyway, so, you know. Hey. Yeah, I actually, I live up in Yonkers. Anybody from Yonkers? Good, I need a fucking ride home. But anyway, I just put a skylight in my apartment, you know, and it's beautiful, but the chick upstairs is pissed off at me, you know what I mean? That's my bit. I'm actually seeing the girl next door. I got binoculars. She doesn't shave her legs, she just kind of like puts them up in curlers, you know what I mean? Okay, listen, let me just do a little character, then I'll get off, give someone else a chance. Give me a second to get ready here. Hold on, it's a good one. How the fuck is it New York? I love New York. You know what I'm saying? In Alabama, I'm motherfucking John Travolta. You know what I'm saying? But it's weird because when I was a kid, I was actually breastfed by my grandmother.
Oh my God.
And now when I go buy milk, I look for the expired date on top of the gallon. You know what I'm saying? No, that ain't right. Okay. And it was actually, I was breastfed through a straw, too, so I'm really fucking weird, you know? I almost got a rupture from sucking on the goddamn thing, you know what I'm saying? But, let me tell you a little, I was actually an unwanted child. I'm not saying I was unwanted, but I was born with a coat hanger sticking out of my fucking head, you know what I'm saying? Oh, that's crazy. So now, what I do, welcome to the Happy Land Disco, by the way. We're about one fucking grease fire away from eternity in this goddamn place. Look out, Jesus Christ. Yeah, I love my grandma, let me tell you, she's good. This one girl was out front, real pretty, you know, she dressed up. I was like, hey, how you doing? She started getting nasty, so I called her a cheap whore, and she hit me with a bag of quarters. That shit ain't right. Now, it's the way you say things in life, you know what I mean? Like, you can say, oh yeah, she had a crack baby. She had a crack baby. Or you can say, she had a crack baby. You see, it's all how you say things. It's kind of weird and shit, you know what I mean? I was actually wanting to produce a show with Dr. Ruth Westheimer and Bob Villa. I want to call it This Old Vagina. She's so old, her vagina has mice. Hey, whoa, I'm the bad guy. Oh. So anyway, it's nice to be here in New York, you know, everyone's having a good time, we're back laughing again, right? We were sad for a little more fucking while, but, you know, we're good now. Right? All right, we're having a good time. Let me just think a little bit of something. You know, it's kind of weird, though, being up here and, you know, a handsome fellow like myself. You know what I'm saying? I got chicks all, I'm like a chick magnet. But I ain't gonna front. Check me out. I got it going on. Shit. You know what I'm saying? On and on and on and on and on. You know what I'm saying? I'm a regular motherfucking, what's in the Q-tip? That's it. Vanilla Ice Hole, they used to call me. That's me, hey. Aren't you Vanilla Ice Hole? Let's see what we got here. Oh, yeah. Now, well, I'm going to leave you with this. As a New Yorker goofing on people from the South, I don't realize how all of a sudden they have 7 inches of rain and 40 fucking people die. How is that? 7 inches of rain? That shit comes up to here. What the fuck? What do you got, midgets? We got a bunch of fucking midgets running around in Mississippi? Jesus Christ, break that shit down for me, man. Oh, damn. Fucking terrible. Jesus. And I'm the bad guy, you know what I'm saying? So what I wanted to do is I wanted to open up a, you know, girls are getting pregnant at such an early age, they got a birth control pill shaped like Fred Flintstone. You know what I mean? Kind of a weird fucking thing. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually open up a drive-thru abortion clinic in the Bronx. I'm going to call it Hands or Us. Come on. Oh, everyone hates the entrepreneur. Hands or Us, that'd be great, you know what I'm saying? And I figure we can sell shoes too, because while we got the feet up in the stirrups, let's take a look at them. Oh, you ain't right. Well, listen, this fucking guy right here is trying to tell me to get the hell out of here. Goddamn New Yorker. And listen, my name's Brian Cannon. You can listen to me on 93.5 FM. Thank you very much. Have a great time.